So as you can see, this power amp is beautiful, beautiful. I just cleaned it, it is like new. It is unbelievable how beautiful this thing is. And I didn't even clean it perfectly, just quickly with a wet towel, and look how beautiful the thing is. And then I opened the pre-amplifier, and because the guy I bought it from told me the balance knob was scratchy. So this is the balance knob, and I cleaned it. I cleaned the pot meter from the balance knob, and I cleaned them all. I cleaned them all. And look how new this thing is looking from the inside. Like this thing wasn't used much. This is the headphone board, as you can see, this thing, yeah. This thing is written here, headphone board, yeah. Headphone board. And this is the selector board, as you can see. All this is the selector board. And well, this is the underside of the preamp, yeah. And well, I don't know, it's connected with strange screws, but I managed to get it off. And well, the thing is looking unbelievable. This Tandberg, this company knew how to make quality. I recognize quality when I open a thing, and this is really, look how they make this thick soldiers, unbelievable thick soldiers. I'm gonna close it down, and I come back with a sound test, a little sound test to see if the thing is working, because I bought the thing on good faith. Yeah, I saw the guy's face and I thought, okay, this guy is telling the truth. He is telling the truth. He is telling me that this thing is working. And I believed him. I believed him on his word, because like I told you before, I'm a face reader. And I can see if somebody's lying. Yeah. And this guy wasn't lying. And so I bought the thing. I just bought the thing without hesitation. But even if the thing was broken, the 75 euro I paid, well, even a broken thing, even if it was broken, it is worth 75 euros. So, if I connect it in 5 minutes and the thing is still working, or the thing is working perfectly, I did a superb deal. And, well, okay, let me screw the thing back. And then you will see, we will see, yes, because I'm curious too, if the thing is working or not, okay? So I cleaned the two devices, and but first I want to show you this. I've got the complete booklets with the circuit diagram, as you can see here, yeah. And and according to the guy I bought it from, this is a unique thing, and I'm not sure if it is unique. But anyway, this is what is inside, and let me see, this is the control amplifier, and as you saw, this is how you have to connect the thing. Anyway, let me see, I didn't open the power amp because it wasn't necessary, everything is working fine, and but this is how the power amp is looking, and it is pretty impressive. There's a picture here, let me see, where is the picture? Yeah, I've got it here. This is how the power amp is looking from the inside. Pretty big travel over there. 8 transistors. And I believe only 2 filter caps. I'm not sure. Maybe there are also 2 on the downside. I'm not sure if there are only 2 or 4. I can't see it from this side. It has 5 different connection, no, 5 different protection circuits. And it is protected against speaker loads lower than 2 ohms, so it can handle 2 ohm speakers. Wow. Wow. The power supply can handle 25 ampere. Wow. No, there are only 2 filter caps. You can read it here. You can read it here. The filter caps in the power supplies in the are 2 times 15,000 UF, and the total power system is able to supply any current needed to the amplifiers, even when handling high power transist signals. Unbelievable. Look how they make it, with all the vent holes on top of. It's very nice how they build it. Anyway, you want to know how the thing sounds. Well, before I go to that, I want to show you how this thing is looking when it is cleaned. It is all cleaned up. I took away the paper. It was over here. You can still see some left over, but it's clean now. It's clean. It left a little mark, as you can see. And over here, it was gum. It was on paper glued on this preamplifier. And the guy already took one away, and why he didn't took the other ones away was because of this. Here is something left, some glue left, I forget, I just see it now. Yeah, but it's easy to take away. And as you see, because of cleaning, the main, you can still read, but the volume is almost gone. Also two, I don't know if you can see it, where is it? Two here, these 2 points here, over here, are faded away because of the cleaning. I cleaned often devices, and some devices just can't handle it. And other devices, you can just clean, and nothing will fade away. But some devices have a little paint layer, only one paint layer, one thin paint layer, and once you get cleaning, that paint layer is gone. So always be aware when you clean something, be careful with the lettering, yeah, because now you cannot read main volume. And that's not a big issue, because I prefer this thing than scratches, and the thing don't have scratches at all. It have a little thing here in the corner, I don't know if you can see it, right here in the corner, up above it, two little points. But when I go with my finger like this, I don't feel nothing at all. And that's a good sign. On top there is more. I have one here, little thing, you can see it, one here. And one here, a little thing. Yeah, you can see it. And that's all. A little scratch over here. I don't know if you can see it. A little scratch. And a very little scratch, you hardly can see it over here. Over here. And a little thing here. So that's all. And for the rest, the thing is mint. And the thing is already 36 years old, 35 years old, and the thing is almost mint. And I cleaned all the pot meters, and let's do the sound. Let's do the sound, and then I will tell you what I discover, what I think from the sound. And I will do a test. I will do another test with this amp, but I will tell you later in the end of the video what kind of test this will be. Okay, so let's do the
the music. Let's do the music, and so you can.
Okay, my findings, listen to this carefully. I think when I compare it with the Sansui TA500 I just cleaned, this thing sounds clear, detailed. But
there is, I don't like this sound. I don't like this sound at all. It is so, it is a clinical sound. It is no warmth, no depth. It I can't explain it, but I will do a test. I will do a test with my Akai. My Akai over there, the AM93. With the Sansui, G901 dB. And I will see upstairs if I can find another, maybe my Harman Kardon, the twin drive, the 930 twin. And I will do a test between these four, and I am sure this thing will not win, because the sound is so clinical. I don't like this sound. But the sound is completely clear, and even if I put some bass, listen, I don't like the sound. I don't, maybe when I put loudness, the sound is coming better, but I play my Akai without loudness, yeah, just neutral, and I love the sound, yeah, but I don't like this sound on neutral, the sound from this. Well, maybe it is because of the speakers, and that's why I say, maybe when I test them with my big speakers, my Canton Karat speakers, maybe that all change. But for now, on these speakers, this thing doesn't sound nice. I have to put one stripe treble back, yeah, three stripes bass extra, and then the sound is perfect. Whitney. I was a fan from Whitney. I love this woman, really. The most beautiful voice.
Ocean is hanging on the nighttime, a woman down in the tunnel.
I had some remarks on on this thing, and the guy told me, well, one of my viewers in the comments, well, hook this thing up and throw that Akai away. Well, not in that words, but anyway, believe me, my Akai sounds better. And we will see this in the test, and to convince everybody that my Akai is the better sounding one. And I not look, be honest, I know what it sound, yeah, and I, of course, my Sansui sounds better. My Sansui G901DB, that's really, I can't describe that sound. That sound is just the best I ever heard, yeah, from all Sansuis. There's these big G series. Yeah, if it is for you only for the sound, and you don't, well, it's not important the money, yeah, go for a Sansui G series. Yeah, you can compare a Sansui G series with a setup like this. Yeah, even if the thing have a big power, 2x150 watt, and my speakers are 4 ohm, so they change in 2x250 watt. This thing, even then. And even if it is built like a tank and with all the specs correct, it cannot even come close to that Sansui G901DB. And my Akai can. My Akai comes very, very close. Yeah. Okay, still not, but you know, it is the price, the big price difference. I have this Akai for nothing, because I bought the complete set, yes, for €150. I sold the CD for the same amount, so I have this Akai amplifier and tuner for free. So why should I kept this expensive Sansui over there? It's too expensive for me. Of course there is a sound difference, but the sound difference isn't worth €1,000 for me, okay? That's why I keep this Akai, and the Sansui is too big. It doesn't fit in this cabinet. It doesn't fit in this cabinet. So for this Sansui, I have to build a complete new cabinet or a wooden cabinet, and I don't like this. I like this style with the glass, yes? And so it only fits on the table over there. You can see over there in the corner. It only fits over there. So anyway, but this thing, I think that the value is around, when I heard this sound, yes, €100-150, believe me. If it is for you, if you're not a collector, just, yeah, because if you are a collector, you want this thing in your collection, it's a beautiful piece of art, really a beautiful piece of art. And everything metal, aluminium, beautiful, beautiful build, beautiful make. And if you are that collector, because this is not my style of collecting or my style of what I like, but you have collectors who like to collect things like this, and this is already 35 years old. It is almost vintage, yeah. And well, to be honest, I'm a little bit disappointed. I thought before I hooked this thing on, I thought, well, this thing will maybe surpass my Akai, but it, to be honest, it doesn't even come close, yeah. And well, you will see in my next video my test, I will test my Akai against my Sansui, and you will know why I think the Sansui is the better sounding one. You will see in that movie, but I will also put this one in the test, yeah, the sound test, and I will see what I can find upstairs, yes, what I can place more in that test. This is Vlak, yeah? This is Vlak. This is a Vlak song. But listen to this song, it is too clean. suddenly I remind me that I have also I made a movie with this song. I tested my Technics 1200 SL 1200 with this song, Me and Mrs. Jones, and suddenly I realized me that maybe this setup is made for phonos, for turntables, yeah, because turntables sound a little bit deeper than the normal, well, flux or MP3 or wave. So maybe with a turntable this thing will sound better, but I'm not sure. Anyway, I tested yesterday on my tuner, yeah. I tested it yesterday also on this thing, and today I tested it on this because I start filming yesterday, yeah, and when I did the cleaning job I did a little sound test, and then I thought, well, I have to play some new music on my phone. Maybe the music quality isn't okay, so I put some new music, some flux between, and I think maybe that's the reason. But still, I when I play this thing over my Akai, the sound is just beautiful, you know, and just how I like it, yeah. Not complete, yeah. What I like is the Soundsuite G series, G9000, but this thing doesn't even come close. And it is clean. You can hear that it's a very expensive thing, because I have different amplifiers, yes, integrated amplifiers. They are not as clean. They are not as clean as this one. My Akai is clean, but it is also warm. You understand? And this thing is only clean. It doesn't have any warmth or depth inside. I'm not sure how to explain it, but yeah. Some songs sounds okay, yeah. I mean, a song like this, Money for Nothing, Dire Straits, flat quality, yes. I mean, this thing, yes, have to sound deep. The bass have to sound deep, and believe me, these speakers are okay. I will do the test on my the test between the Akai, and I will do it on my big speakers, on my Canton speaker. But these speakers have bass, you know, so. A long time I don't play loudness anymore, but if this setup was my only thing in my house, I would only play it with loudness on, because listen to the difference. Because the sound is so flat, unbelievable flat. I don't like this sound. And you will see in my next video, I'm not sure when I will come out with that video, but you will see in my next video how this thing sounds in comparison with my Akai over there with the Soundsuite. And I'm not sure what is my fourth receiver or amplifier. Maybe you can suggest me. I have a Marantz PM80 MK2. I don't like that sound, yeah. What more? I have... well, maybe I will put my Akai AM2800 between it. Yeah, yeah. My Akai AM2800. I will do that Akai between it. And you will hear what is good sound. I prefer the Akai 2800 sound above this sound. Really, really. And I'm disappointed. And It's nothing to do with that something is wrong with this thing, something is broken with this thing. You saw that one of the switches were dirty. This one, yeah. This switch is dirty. I didn't clean the switches, but that's all, yeah. If I put this thing off, it is no problem for the sound. This is just how it have to sound, yeah. And maybe it's not a good connection with the speakers. Maybe with other speakers this thing sounds completely different. That's why I'm not 100% sure. I'm disappointed now with this combination, yeah. But maybe with the Cantons, because the Cantons go a little bit deeper, maybe then this thing is completely different. Yeah, maybe my opinion is completely different. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, put your thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe on my channel. For now, I say bye bye.